I found this absolutely extraordinary. Harry, Meghan, and Oprah, that interview that we've spoken about so much and contains so much fiction, has ended up being nominated for an Emmy for Best Non-Fiction Series. Oh, the irony, Meghan, the irony.
It's absurd. And you know, let's say these nominations came out the day after the interview. Maybe you give them a pass. The Emmys, they didn't have a chance. BS. Because now we know that not only did Meghan Markle tell a bunch of whoppers in that interview, but that night during the interview, Dan, I was tweeting out, I wanted more follow-ups. Why didn't she ask who in the royal family, for example, was jealous of Kate after the Australia tour? Who or was jealous of Meghan? Who in the royal family said the thing about skin color? Get specific. If she doesn't want to answer, ask two or three follow-up questions. That's a huge allegation. And even her saying that she was married, you know, 3 days before she had the actual wedding, Oprah had time between the interview and the day it aired. They spent days and days editing that piece. As a journalist, you can find out. You call the Archbishop. You can ask questions and get real answers and include in your report, we went to the Archbishop and asked, and this is what we found. That wasn't quite true. None of that was done. This is about celebrity and trying to celebrate, you know, these two women who are women of color, you know, speaking their truth, even though it wasn't actual truth. You know, we're supposed to be with a lived experience, even if it bears no relation to actual reality, and celebrate them. If you're not pro all of that, Dan, you're a racist, sexist pig. So vote for someone else.
Oh my goodness, I would love to see Meghan Kelly versus Meghan Markle. That's where it would be at. It would be fascinating, yeah. Meghan.